very cruel joke on me last night. At the Bowl for Blue Awards, nobody told me the blue punch in the back wasn't Kool-Aid. So I brought my own today. It's just water. All right, so thank you so much. It's a pleasure to have you all here today. What we want to do is talk about the, we talked about the Bowl for Blue Awards last night. And you know, we had a great ceremony, but when we were going over the nominations, we were the nominating committee. I said, well, look, what about those people who continuously go out every day, especially on social media, and they tell the story about prostate cancer? They share some of their own stories, they're inspirational. And so I said, well, what if we created the Megaphone Award? And the megaphone, of course, is that instrument used to project your voice and your thoughts. And so that's why we came up with the Megaphone Award. And I want to show you a quick video that will highlight some of the guests that we have.
I was thinking about my two adult kids. I was thinking about my young son that my husband and I had worked so hard to adopt. I was wondering how I was going to be able to take care of them. Will I be able to continue with my responsibilities of being a supportive father or a spouse? But at the end of the day, I just wanted to live.
John had a normal PSA, and then several months later, he was stage 4, and then 3 months later, he had died. And so, it's so imperative to not take prostate cancer lightly.
It's interesting because I look at some of the analytics on my Twitter posts, and there won't be a lot of likes, but there'll be a ton of interaction. So you'll see that people clicked on the articles. It's funny because I've met people at races that come up to me and only know me because of social media.
My nickname is a bounty hunter, and the reason why I'm a bounty hunter is because when we do our health fair events and I see men look at our sign and say prostate cancer and they turn and go the other way, I go get them, bring them back, try to educate them. I have a passion because I'm a stage 4 prostate cancer survivor and I don't want any other men to have to go through what I went through.
And I needed to get to the gym. This man was in the gym at 2:45. Anybody who's following his page. Caesar, thank you so much for being an inspiration to us all.